Between the security of childhood and responsibilities of adulthood comes the fascinating group of humans called Marines. They come in all sizes and shapes and uniforms and can usually be found on ships, in bunkers, embassy duty, in love, in bars, in jail, or in debt. Towns tolerate them and the government pays them. A Marine is a brave man with a tattooed arm, deadly with a deck of cards, an occasional drinker, a defender of our country with a Playboy pinup in his pocket. A Marine has the slyness of a fox, the energy of a bull, and the appetite of a Bowery bum. He dislikes answering questions or letters, wearing a uniform, his superior officers, and reveille. No one else can cram into his pockets a church key, a crushed pack of Camels, a set of chopsticks, cigarette lighter, a comb, an autographed picture of his girl, and a few cents from last week's pay. Still, he wears his uniform in a military manner, with cut-off sleeves and a snag from barbed wire. Always keeping on the alert and observing every girl within sight or hearing. A Marine likes to spend his money on beer, whiskey, cards, and women. The rest, he spends foolishly. If he's not requesting special liberty, he's demanding leave. Upon denial of these things, he will request a transfer. Only a Marine can sit in a muddy foxhole with a can of ham and lima beans in his hand, a soggy pack of C-Rat cigarettes in his pocket, rain pouring down, and still complain that he's not getting enough benefits. A Marine is a magical creature. You can take him off your mailing list, but not out of your heart. You can lock him out of your house, but not out of your mind. You might as well give up. He's your love away from home, a good-for-nothing housewife. But all your heartaches are soon forgotten when he wanders home and looks at you with tired, bloodshot eyes and says to you, "Hi, Mom. I love you."